My friend Joe went on the Dolly Parton diet. It made Joe lean, Joe lean, Joe lean, Joe lean. Today, I'm going to recap a 2022 action fantasy film called Morbius. The film opens in Costa Rica, where a group of researchers arrive at the entrance of a cave. The expedition's leader, Dr. Michael Morbius, instructs the team to place a trap near the entrance. He proceeds to slice his palm, intending to attract the creature lurking within the cave. A horde of bats emerges and flies out, prompting the team to retreat to their helicopter. However, Morbius remains motionless, as if anticipating something else. The scene transitions to Greece, 25 years earlier, focusing on a young Michael Morbius. Dr. Emil Nicholas introduces Lucian to Morbius, both of whom suffer from a blood disorder and are under the doctor's care. Upon their initial conversation, Morbius quickly nicknames Lucian Milo, as the previous child there was named as such. As they converse, Milo's machine suddenly malfunctions, causing him to lose consciousness. Morbius repairs the device with a pen spring, reviving Milo. Impressed by Morbius' intellect, the doctor arranges for his transfer to an elite school in New York. After Morbius leaves, bullies accost and assault Milo, only to be stopped by Dr. Nicholas. In short, the adult Morbius earns his doctoral degree by the age of 19, becoming renowned for his efforts to cure bloodborne diseases. He is awarded a Nobel Prize in Sweden, but declines the honor. Morbius continues his work, treating Anna, who has the same illness as him. At the hospital, he collaborates with his girlfriend, Dr. Martine Bancroft, who believes Morbius is overexerting himself. Martine mentions a man named Milo, the benefactor for their project combining human and bat DNA. Morbius had kept bats from the earlier cave for further study, convinced they hold the key to curing the disease. Martine questions his hypothesis, prompting Morbius to test his serum on a lab rat as proof. The rat dies, and Anna experiences a seizure. They rush to Anna's room and induce a coma to prevent a stroke. Later, Martine discovers the lab rat is alive, leading them to conclude the serum works. Morbius informs Milo and Nicholas of the breakthrough and meets with them in a park. Morbius requests additional funding to continue his experiments in international waters, as they aren't entirely legal. He emphasizes the urgency, as time is running out for both him and Milo. In summary, the ship sets sail for international waters, with Martine accompanying Morbius to provide assistance. After ensuring the serum's safety, Morbius decides to conduct a human trial. Martine injects Morbius with the serum and secures him to prevent any mishaps. A crew member enters the lab and discovers Morbius has escaped. They find him crawling on the ceiling in the isolation room. The man attempts to shoot Morbius, but the now vampire creature attacks first. Mercenaries arrive at the lab, with one of them knocking Martine unconscious. The monstrous Morbius shatters the glass and assaults the mercenaries. He flees the lab, hunting down and killing the remaining survivors on the ship. Morbius eventually awakens, regaining his humanity and discovering his body has undergone a remarkable transformation. He proceeds to the control room and views footage of himself, attacking the men and draining their blood from the security cameras. Morbius sends out a mayday call, grabs some serums, and leaps into the ocean. The following day, FBI agent Simon Stroud and Rodriguez arrive at the ship to examine the crime scene. They discover Martine alive, but unfortunately, Morbius has erased all the surveillance recordings. Meanwhile, Nicholas and Milo learn about the incident from the news. Morbius returns to the hospital and immediately heads to his lab where he consumes blood samples to satiate his thirst. Once barely able to walk, Morbius now has incredible speed and strength. He enters the bat enclosure, and the bats accept him as their leader. He later finds that artificial blood cannot sustain him for extended periods. Just as Morbius is about to revert to his monstrous state, Milo appears and assists him in regaining control by providing more blood samples. Milo, now aware that Morbius is completely cured, wants the serum injection too, but Morbius declines due to its uncontrollable nature. Milo persists and Morbius expels him from the lab. The FBI agents question Martine about the horrifying incident, but she remains silent. That evening, a nurse falls victim to a vampiric creature. Morbius learns of the nurse's death and realizes he wasn't responsible. As he tries to leave, the agents confront him about the ship incident and attempt to arrest him. Morbius retaliates and assaults them, then tries to escape by scaling the hospital with his newfound abilities. However, he is eventually caught and taken to a detention center. Stroud and Rodriguez interrogate him and accuse him of murdering the nurse. Morbius becomes unstable and requests artificial blood, but the agents leave without complying. Shortly after, Milo visits him and provides a pack of artificial blood before departing, leaving his cane behind. Morbius deduces that Milo took the serum and killed the nurse. Transforming into the vampiric beast again, he breaks out of the facility to pursue his best friend. Milo, now also a monster, kills a man. Morbius confronts him, warning him about the power's dangers, but Milo attacks him instead. Their confrontation leads them to a subway station, where officers arrive to apprehend Milo. He effortlessly kills them all. Milo challenges Morbius to a fight, but Morbius flees through the tunnel. The agents arrive at the scene and blame Morbius for the officers' deaths. Meanwhile, Martine is discharged from the hospital. The next morning, Morbius meets her on a bus, explaining his situation and informing her about Milo. He asks for her help as the artificial blood loses its efficacy in restraining his inner monster. Afterward, Morbius trails two thugs from a cafe to their lab, where he politely requests they hand over the facility to him. One man tries to stab him, but Morbius easily overpowers him. The other thugs flee, and Morbius continues to develop a serum to prevent his transformation. On the other hand, Milo visits a nightclub where he flirts with an attractive woman, but a burly man takes offense. Fortunately, Milo maintains control over his newfound abilities. Later that evening, he tails the man and his friends, eventually killing them all. The agents and several officers raid Martine's residence, but find no one there. As it turns out, Martine is collaborating with Morbius in his new lab, where they ultimately share a kiss. Unbeknownst to them, Milo spies on them from a distance. The following day, the FBI agents discover the slain club patrons and, through surveillance footage, learn that Milo is the actual perpetrator, not Morbius. After hearing about the massacre on the news, Dr. Nicholas confronts Milo, who has become increasingly obsessed with his new superpower. An argument ensues when Milo expresses resentment over Nicholas always favoring Morbius over him. Milo attacks the doctor, leaving him gravely injured. Meanwhile, Morbius completes the development of an antibody harmful to his vampiric form and plans to administer the poison to both himself and Milo. Soon after, he receives a call from Nicholas and hurries to his location, but arrives too late to save him. Milo infiltrates the lab and abducts Martine. Using his heightened senses, Morbius quickly locates her, but finds her seriously injured by Milo. With time running out, Martine permits Morbius to drink her blood to pursue Milo, but a small drop of Morbius's blood inadvertently enters her mouth. Enraged, Morbius attacks his former friend, leading to a fierce battle between the two vampiric beings. They fly and crash through various locations until they reach an underground tunnel, where Morbius summons a swarm of bats to encircle Milo. Seizing the opportunity, Morbius injects Milo with the antibody, causing him to lose his strength and ultimately die. As the police arrive, Morbius, concealed by the bats, escapes while Martine is reborn as a vampire. In the post-credits scene, a multiversal rift from the Spider-Man movie opens up, transporting Adrian Toomes to this universe. Somehow freed from his cell, he meets Morbius and proposes they join forces for a greater cause. If you enjoyed this video, don't be shy to hit the like button, and if you disliked it, hit the dislike button twice, just to be sure. It would be best if you watched the whole movie. Thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this.